This is Bazaar Morning Call, broadcasting live from the CNBC TV 18 Motilal Oswal Studios in Mumbai.
Good morning. You're with us here on a fresh new edition of Bazaar Morning Call. It's a rainy Wednesday morning. We are coming to you live from the CNBC TV 18 Motilal Oswal Studios. I'm Prashant. With me, my colleagues Nigel and Reema. Guys, hi, morning.
Hi, morning. Good morning. 6 days of games on the trot, 4 record closes. The question is, what next, right?
What next? And Nigel is coming back from the land of the Puchka.
City of joy.
City of
it
joy.
It was as hot as ever. There's
no rain.
Not a drop of rain out there. So I took off. The flight was a little bit delayed because of the weather. Mm. Landed as hot as ever. Not a drop of rain all through the day. And came back here. It was pouring yet again. It took more than an hour from the airport to home at 10:30 in the night. So
Looking at the rain yesterday in the evening, I thought it's going to be one of those all-nighters, right? It rained all the way till the morning, and then it becomes a mess in the morning. But thankfully.
And today's looking a little better. I think so. Let's hope for the best.
All right. Well, let's quickly tell you what you need to know, which is, in terms of new information, not very much, because U.S. markets were shut. U.S. markets were shut for the 4th of July holiday, so no queues out of there. So we kind of start trading off of our own steam in terms of where we left off yesterday. And yesterday was interesting in terms of the price action. By the way, I just want to start by making this one point that the Nifty is now up 700 points in the last five sessions, 698 to be precise. That is as fast as they come. Even, we've had similar instances in the past. I mean, it happens once in a while. But after we took out, or rather around the time that we were about to take off the previous all-time high, the pace gathered momentum, and then it's been gaps and gaps and gaps. Yesterday, we got the first signal that after such a large gain in a very compressed time frame, the conviction whether this is going to continue at the same pace is starting to falter a little bit. So, the Nifty closed slightly above the upper end of the rising channel. Yes, that is true, by about 40, 45 points. But the Nifty also formed what is called a doji candlestick pattern, which is nothing but simply the fact that the opening and the closing levels were the same. What this kind of indicates is indecision. It's kind of right in the middle of the range if you just look at the daily chart. Actually, it's true for the Nifty and the Bank Nifty as well. The low yesterday, which was made at 10 in the morning, was 19,300. The high, which was made, was 19,434. So, with the doji pattern yesterday, the low of yesterday, which is 19,300, is to be watched on the downside. A break below it, a close below it, perhaps leads us to a near-term pullback, some sort of consolidation. And I think that would not be bad at all, given the pace of the move that we've had. So 19,300 on the downside. And then, of course, below that, you get the 20-day, the 40-day exponential moving average and things like that. But those are distance away. So keep 19,300 as the first kind of stop. Alternately, it's possible the market runs away. I would say the chances of that after so much in the back perhaps are, the probability of that is a little lower. But the targets on the upside are around 19,500 or so. Bank Nifty also saw what is a doji candlestick pattern, as I explained. Bank Nifty could see some pullback consolidation, similar kind of levels. The low yesterday was 45,000. So keep that as the lower bound as a bit of a trailing reversal stop. Nothing permanent, but it could lead to a breach below it, could lead to a bit of a pullback, a consolidation, sideways price action. On the upside, for the Bank Nifty, the weekly Bollinger Band stands at 46,000. It's not exactly, it's 46,000 and some change, but 46,000 roughly is the upper level, the upper bound that we could perhaps work with. Pace of gains, I think this we saw day before yesterday and yesterday as well. Pace of gains in both the mid and the small cap side of the market is slowing a little bit. Mid caps actually ended lower. And unlike day before yesterday, where mid caps were soft but small caps rallied, yesterday small caps also gave up gains and we ended absolutely flat there as well. So again, this is a space which has seen gains coming through very, very thick and fast. The GIFT Nifty on your screen indicating a flattish kind of start, 1450-odd points higher. Yesterday also, by the way, the GIFT Nifty was not indicating a big gap up, but we got a big gap up, which got promptly sold into, and we made that day's low early on by about 10 a.m. or so. So watch the price action. I would say maybe time for some consolidation, time to catch our collective breaths in the face of this very, very steep rally. Reema.
Hi, and watch for the mid-cap action, right? You are seeing some signs of fatigue, profit booking, pullback. No steep correction because the Nifty mid-cap index only sold off 0.5% from the day's high. So there is no sharp correction or a sharp reversal, but you are seeing some signs of profit taking. So yesterday, the Nifty mid-cap index snapped a 5-day winning streak. The advanced decline ratio closed well in favor of the losing side. We had about 3 stocks in the green for 4 in the red. In terms of flows, the FIs continue to pump in money. Yesterday, they bought 2,100 crore in the cash market. The DII sold 785 crore. The Bajaj twins, Bajaj Finance and Bajaj FinServ, saw some very large delivery volumes. Between the two, 1,500 crore of delivery volumes. Eicher Motors, which sold off one of the biggest, you know, one-day losses for Eicher Motors in many, many months and years, Eicher Motors saw delivery volumes of 720 crore. In terms of the provisional updates that are coming through from the banking space, largely good. But, you know, Nigel, there are some wrinkles. For instance, Bandhan Bank's loan growth has moderated to just 7%. I think in the prior quarter, it was 10%. Mm-hmm. For AU Small Finance Bank, the management is talking about increased cost of funds, which means NIMS could come under pressure. RBL's bank, deposit growth is just up less than 1% on a quarter-on-quarter basis. Innocent Bank's numbers look good and HDFC banks are up for you on your screen. But there are, it's not all guns blazing when you look at the provisional banking updates from the banks. There are a few wrinkles.
Well, that's right, Reema. You know, before we get to the market action, today is a big day, actually, because it's a party up in heaven. You know, big bull Rakesh Jhunjhunwala would have been celebrating his birthday as well. Mm-hmm. So, you know, there's a party in heaven. There's a party on the Lal Street as well. And one thing I remember that Mr. Rakesh Jhunjhunwala always said is, just ignore the noise and stay bullish on India. You know, that was been his mantra, his theme. So, you know, just thought I'll mention that at the start of my chat today. But let's focus on the markets. Have the Indian markets paused for breath? Or was yesterday the consolidation that we're looking at? Because you're just comparing Nifty as well as the Nifty Bank's performance yesterday. And you compare it with the 4-day average. So it's a little bit lower, both on the Nifty as well as the Nifty Bank. Is this the consolidation or are we in for a period of few days of maybe consolidation, or, you know, catch your breath? I think that would be healthy as well. Yesterday, the headline index, no worries. The Nifty was up. The IT index did pretty well. And the Nifty Financial Services Index, well, that played out expiry. So that was the factor that played around. That's why that has moved to around 20,500 odd with the names like the Bajaj Twins, you know, which are not part of the Nifty Bank, but they're part of the Nifty Financial Services Index. But from the broader markets, the Nifty Next 50, that was under some pressure. The mid-cap index ended in the red. And the small-cap index as well didn't outperform yesterday. So that's telling you that maybe the broader markets have already started consolidating a little bit. And I reiterate, this is an encouraging, this is the healthy sign for the markets. What do the FIs do? They are going in all out. They're putting in money in the cash market. They added long positions close on 14,000 contracts. And now their gross long positions, just take a look at that number. It's almost 1.5 lakh contracts. That's the highest I've seen in a while. And the long positioning now has moved to around 72%. We have seen in the past, whether it's on the short or the long positioning, once it reaches that 75, 80, 85% odd, then we think that things are getting a little bit too comfortable for comfort. So, you know, so let's keep an eye out on that front. Two strikes I'm looking at. One is the 19,400 put. When out there, you had a fair bit of writing that was seen with the premium at around 70 rupees odd. So we'll plug in the numbers in just a bit. But the 19,400 call, that is the strike that has the highest open interest. On the call side, more than a crore shares out there. Premiums around 52 rupees odd. You know, you had the open interest that was up by close to around 28 lakhs yesterday. So the PCR is still closer to around 1.5. Yesterday as well, you know, the India VIX from those bombed out levels, that was a little bit higher on a day that the Nifty ended higher. So let's get the levels up for you on the screen. I think resistance zone is at around 19,450 going by the call writing. And that could be the zone that the bears want to defend. You know, they've not been able to defend anything. But on the downside, till this 19,270 odd level is holding out, well, you'll see that that uptrend is pretty much intact. So some consolidation, that'll be healthy for the markets. Let's see whether or not today's the day for that. GIFT Nifty is suggesting 15 points higher.
All right, Nigel. Well, let's, you know, let's hope that there is, you know, some consolidation. Then there is more fuel in the tank, so as to say, and we don't kind of exhaust all of it out with the current move, the sharp move that we're seeing. Well, let's quickly tell you what's lined up in the first half hour of the show. We get you updates from around the globe. Abhilash Narayan of Standard Chartered Bank will join us to discuss the global setup. Our research team will get you CNBC TV18's list of top 10 stocks for the day. And Deven Choksi joins us at 8:30 to discuss the stocks which have news flow and things that he likes to bet on now as well.
On the equities, Vikas Shen of CLSA says that data readings suggest growth is likely to notably miss the official growth forecast of 8% year-on-year for the April-June quarter. He says almost 40% of the core indicators are suggesting notably lower in the quarter-to-date economic growth, while only one-fourth are suggesting a beat, one-fifth see growth as in line with the official forecast. He says consumption indicators have led to a month-on-month improvement. He adds industrial activity has disappointed for the second consecutive month, led by a slowdown in exports, electricity generation and logistics. He says early indicators for June point to some month-on-month improvement, but it may be tough to catch the official quarterly GDP growth forecast of 8%.
Okay, let's get you some money market views as well. On the rupee, Kunal Sadani of Shinhan Bank says that resilient U.S. economic data justifies Fed's tightening stance, but lower inflation numbers weighs on the U.S. dollar. Markets are now awaiting the upcoming non-farm payrolls data, the jobs data, and FOMC minutes for further direction. Dollar-yuan pair is now cooling off. For the rupee, Kunal says 81.85 to a dollar acts as a support, while 82.2 to a dollar is a resistance.
On the bonds, Neeraj Gambhir of Axis Bank says bond yields hardened, tracking the rise in U.S. Treasury yields as stronger than expected U.S. GDP data for the Jan-March period and initial jobless claims data intensified fears of further rate hikes by the Federal Reserve. Moreover, he says GSEC auction cutoffs came in worse than expected, causing the 10-year benchmark bond yield to break 7.10%. He expects the 10-year benchmark bond yield to trade in a range of 7.05 to 7.15% for the rest of the week, ahead of the FOMC minutes and non-farm payroll data.
Well, we have a lot of stock-specific action to track for you, and we'll get to that in just a bit for now in our special Top 10 segment. But there are a whole host of stocks that we're looking at. IOC, Macrotech, developers, Samvardhana Motherson, Strides Pharma, Syngene International. But let's pull up for the stocks on the list. Genius Spa, you have Suzlon Energy, LTI Mindtree, and LIC Housing Finance. All the stocks on the back of positive news flow. While on the banking names, we'll have to see how they react.